Thank you. Hello.
Hello.
Testing. 1, 2, test. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Yes. Yeah.
The fresh baked bread. Piled with extra lean, juicy ham. All the power of extra strength Tylenol combined with innovative Jelco technology. Nothing works faster.
It goes away really, really quick.
In addition, it's equipped with a rugged steel safety cage. You see, we not only want to make accidents easier.
Hello, Fiona.
Hello, hello, hello.
We're back in the living room.
Mm-hmm.
In your work, there is a lot of advertisements. One advertisement that I've seen is pretty close by. I think only 200 meters from here, there is maybe your biggest work.
Yeah, that's correct.
It's an enormous painting above in the back of the station on the outside, and you drive under it. So it's above a tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
And it is, in fact, a big advertisement. What is it for? An advertisement,
In generally or in my work?
No, this specific advertisement.
Oh, this specific.
What does it? What does it sell?
Wheels for heels, little wheels for heels, and a can opener in a can.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
And how did you come up with those objects?
I didn't come up with those ideas, but the people who lived in the area from the wall painting. So we had this prijsvraag,
a competition or a contest.
Yeah, we had like this little competition.
The area and the people that live there.
Yeah,
you asked them to come up with a object they wanted to see there.
Yeah, so and we had this prizes with a lot of weird candy. So one person received like a 20 centimeter long cola candy.
Why the candy?
Just because we can.
Okay.
Yeah, I want to receive candy if we win something.
No, it was a silly question.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Originally, it was like filler ups for a comic that I wanted to create some self-made or self-thought of products or services for in a comic. It was like fillers mostly, but then I thought this is really fun to do, so I decided for the place for the mural above the tunnel. I decided to do a billboard advertisement because it was the perfect place for that. And
yeah, so you're trying to position your advertisement works in places that are
like
advertisement context, like in reality as
they're
well.
They're mostly only seen filled with advertisement, but I think we can use those places or for art.
And that way you just want to get more audience or
because we can show a lot more people more art in more easier way, it's nobody's gonna buy your stuff if you only show it at the museum. Like if you're gonna advertise for watches in the museum, nobody gonna buy your watches. I have to sell art to live, so why not trying to really sell it?
Yeah, there's a value to the art, an economic value to you, to the artworks.
Of course.
That you sell.
Yeah.
There's money coming in.
Yeah.
Why not put them out in an advertisement?
Yeah.
If you position your art like a commercial product, why not be a comic maker in a more traditional sense, like going to a publishing house that does comics and dive into that world instead of being a visual artist?
I've tried it to. I've spoken once with a publisher who did only traditional comics, but we had a different idea of comics, so it didn't work out. Yeah, so I decided to go to a publisher maybe who is more has an artistic background, not only in comic, but also the art, so that you have more free play. And that is what I think being an artist is so much fun. You can experiment and you don't always have to clarify what you are doing. Reality can be motivated by fiction. That's quite interesting for me. That you can realize something that was in the past fiction, now you can realize it with the new technology and you can make it real. So everything that we put in movies and books, or that somebody thought of in their crazy imagination, maybe someday it will be real. That's the fun part of it. Yeah.
So how then would this relate to your work? Like the fictions that you set up, like in the golden hour that you've been working on for the past years, your new comic that will come out.
Yeah.
I think next year or soon.
Soon, yes.
Very soon.
Yes.
How would you say that works, what you're saying now? How does your fiction complete, or reality complete your fiction?
The book The Golden Hour is about the journey after death and then be reborn maybe again, or go to your home planet, or be a ghost. And that's more kind of a joke that is based on the stories my parents told me, and they learned it from a cult, and the cult is called Malva. And yes, they told me about stuff that they couldn't know, and they took it from the cult like that was the truth, but no, it was not verified. So I was like, okay, you're telling me, but I don't believe it. I have to see it first.
As a child,
yes. But I was indoctrinated a little bit, so I believed some parts of it. Yeah, but in my work, I mostly just fantasize about the ideas of my parents, about death and God and aliens and ghosts and all the stuff you can find in fiction movies.
Did you watch television a lot as a child?
No, not that much. We had like these four videotapes, and we watched it like each we watched like 50 times because
really?
Shrek, Harry Potter, De Zwanenprinses,
and
Otje.
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 Well, that's one you learn life from, right?
Yes.
The dad without papers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I once stole a video tape.
Oh.
Because I wanted to watch Mulan so bad, so I stole it.
Which one?
Mulan.
Mulan?
Yeah.
Okay. They did a good marketing job, so you really wanted to see it.
I really wanted to see it.
Oh, okay.
Not from a store, from some other kid who had like lots of videotapes. I was like, she wouldn't miss it.
Right.
I have like four at home, so I deserve this.
Is that karma? There was a karma, right?
My mom, she found out, so she was really angry and had to bring back this videotape and say sorry to the child like hundreds of videotapes. Oh. I think she wouldn't even notice if I just kept it. But so it was really unfair.
I think my mom would do that.
You have like a little bit shit on your hand.
Oh.
Yeah,
We have to take another break. I've got shit on my hand. Thank you so much, Fiona and Pikachu, for this nice talk. We'll
You're
go
well.
Back to Wobby Central now and enjoy the rest of the show.
Yeah.